So last week, the House of Representatives voted along party lines, with only one Republican voting against the measure, to hold Attorney General Merrick Garland, in contempt of Congress for refusing to turn over audio of the investigation into President Biden's classified documents case, which of course ended with President Biden not being criminally charged because the case is nothing at all like what happened with Donald Trump, who willingly withheld documents, lied to authorities about withholding documents, whereas Biden cooperated every step along the way. And there was audio of President Biden talking to the investigators, and that's what House Republicans wanted to get their hands on for some reason. And Merrick Garland said, no, I'm not going to turn it over. So of course they have to hold him in contempt, right? And if that's all you know about this story, then I'm sure that those contempt filing against Merrick Garland makes total sense, right? I mean, Congress says you have to give us this thing. You refuse to give us this thing. Therefore, you should be held in contempt, right? Well, hold up, because there's a lot more to the story. More to the story that conservative media doesn't want to tell you. And look, I am not a fan of Merrick Garland. I would love nothing more than for him to be shown the door and never go back to Washington, D.C. He has been an incredibly weak and ineffective attorney general. But in this particular instance, he actually did nothing wrong. He was following the law, whereas Republicans in Congress are not. They're actually violating the separation of powers of the U.S. Constitution. Because it turns out that the reason Merrick Garland did not turn that audio over to Republicans in the House of Representatives is because President Biden, the current president, claimed executive privilege over it. Executive privilege shields whatever the president wants to shield from Congress, just like it shields it from the court, just like it shields it from the public. And yes, that is written in law. That is part of the separation of powers. If the president, the sitting president, not the former president, claims executive privilege over something, they don't have to give it to Congress. So these contempt filings against Merrick Garland are baseless. He did what he was allowed to do, which was not turn over that information. In fact, had he turned over that information in violation of executive privilege, then you could actually file criminal charges against him, right? Like, that would be the actual crime. If he did what you wanted him to do, he would have been breaking the law. But by not doing what you wanted him to do, he was actually following the law, and you guys are now the ones running afoul of it. If that makes sense to anybody, the point is, these Republicans in the House of Representatives, who have done nothing for a year and a half now, passed the fewest amount of bills in the history of Congress, have driven us to the brink of government shutdown 5 times in 18 months, have nothing better to do than to say, we want to pick on little Merrick Garland. We want to tarnish his reputation, as if it's not tarnished enough. And the guy's not going after white collar criminals. The guy's not going after major polluters. He's not going after the tech industry. He's not doing a damn thing. But in this particular instance, not doing a thing was actually the right thing to do. Merrick Garland was following the law, while Republicans apparently continue to violate it. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.